Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, I am delighted to be with you to celebrate the International Day of the Girl Child. The International Day of the Girl Child is an opportunity to take stock, because before taking action, we must first understand the facts. This day is also an opportunity to spread hope by showing that solutions do exist. In this respect, I am delighted to acknowledge the laureates of the 2020 UNESCO Prize for Girls and Women's Education, also being celebrated today. I would like to warmly thank the prize winners for their commitment to finding solutions for equality, which are so important in these challenging times. They are a reminder that together we can work to ensure that education is a common global good. Whether locally, nationally, or globally, all members of the education community have a role to play, and all society at large. Lastly, I would like to warmly thank the government of the People's Republic of China for its ongoing support for this prize. I would especially like to thank Professor Peng Liyuan, UNESCO's Special Envoy for the Advancement of Girls and Women's Education. By fighting for equal learning opportunities, by passing on knowledge and ensuring that we teach girls how to live, you are ensuring that girls' education contributes to a brighter future. Gan Qinyin, Peng Liyuan Nushi, thank you very much, Professor Peng. I am proud of our joint commitment to equality. Together, we're working to support millions of girls around the world who deserve justice and dignity. I thank you for your attention.
尊敬的阿祖莱总干事、女士们、先生们、朋友们，大家好。 值此国际女童日之际，我谨向联合国教科文组织第五届女童和妇女教育奖的成功评选，向来自斯里兰卡、肯尼亚的获奖者表示衷心的祝贺。在联合国教科文组织引领和推动下，国际社会日益关注和重视女童和妇女教育事业。 越来越多的机构和个人投入这项事业。2015年，中国同联合国教科文组织合作设立女童和妇女教育奖，旨在表彰为促进女童和妇女教育做出突出贡献的机构和个人，展示教育改变女童和妇女命运的重要作用，激励更多人投身 教育性别平等事业。5年来，在这一奖项的颁奖仪式和有关的会议中，我同获奖者们进行了深入的交流，了解到他们投身女童和妇女教育的感人事迹。他们以实际行动帮助女童和妇女获取知识和技能，点燃女童和妇女的人生梦想， 为促进教育性别平等、推动社会发展贡献力量。这种奉献精神令我深受感动。今年获奖的斯里兰卡、肯尼亚的项目为我们更好为女童和妇女提供知识技能，享有教育和发展权益做出了突出贡献。在中国，也有千千万万的人 为女童和妇女教育事业默默耕耘，其中有一位名叫张桂梅的女教师，她扎根云南贫困山区40多年，推动创建了中国第一所免费女子高中。2008年建校以来，已帮助1600多位女孩子圆梦大学校园。 张老师被女孩子们亲切地称为“张妈妈”，她像一束希望之光，照亮孩子们的追梦人生。今年是一个特殊的年份，受新冠肺炎疫情影响，全球15亿学生被迫停课，对女童的影响尤其明显，我对此十分忧心。 在这样一个特殊时刻，我们更要充分发挥女童和妇女教育奖的影响力，增强世界各国对女童和妇女教育事业的关注， 想方设法帮助女童复课复学，不让女童因疫情掉队。女士们、先生们、朋友们，全球成年文盲中63%是女性，让我们深感心情沉重。妇女得不到良好教育，就不会有人类社会发展进步。女童和妇女教育功在当代，利在千秋。作为联合国教科文组织促进女童和妇女教育特使，我在此呼吁更多国家和各界人士积极支持和参与这一伟大事业。中国将继续同教科文组织合作，办好2021年至2025年第二期女童和妇女教育奖，推动国际教育交流合作，为促进女童和妇女教育，实现联合国2030年可持续发展目标做出更大贡献。让我们携手努力，帮助女童和妇女享有平等优质的教育，让女性拥有美好的未来。
The UNESCO Prize for Girls and Women's Education honors outstanding and innovative contributions to advance the education of girls and women. This year, the prize recognizes a project increasing young women's participation in the emerging technology sector in Sri Lanka, and a project increasing access to quality primary school education for vulnerable children, including girls, in Kenya's hardest to reach areas. The two laureates of 2020 are the Shilpa Sayura Foundation for its project Next Gen Girls in Technology, and the Girl Child Network for its project Our Right to Learn, Reaching the Unreached. Next Gen Girls in Technology is an extracurricular program helping young women in high school and university improve their analytical, logical, and creative thinking through technology. In the past 2 years, the Next Gen project has reached all corners of Sri Lanka, training thousands of girls and teachers on in-demand technology sector skills like machine learning, cybersecurity and design, and increasing internship and employment opportunities.
நாங்க இந்த ஐசிடி தான் எடுக்க போறோம். சோ இது இது இந்த இன்ட்ரடக்ஷன் இந்த இந்த நாள்ல கிடைச்சதால
மே தவசனட அப்பி கோமணி கிளாஸ்க்கே தவசடி கணக்கானட வெடிய புரோகிராமிங் கர்மஷோ.
The Our Right to Learn, Reaching the Unreached project empowers girls by addressing cultural, institutional and economic barriers such as early marriage and stigma, preventing girls from accessing and completing their primary education. Since 2012, the project has reached the most marginalized girls in 240 primary schools through education programs, gender and disability-friendly school facilities, and community-based social mobilization, transforming negative attitudes standing in the way of girls' education.
We have been trained by Girl Child Network about menstrual hygiene, which we have trained our kids here.
Each of the laureates will receive an award of $50,000 from the government of the People's Republic of China to help further their work, advancing girls' and women's education